Well, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the war to end all wars, which is something that our Mughal monarch, our current Padishah, Babur II, had envisioned ever since he was little. As we know, he's only 29 years old, and he was inaugurated back in the 8th of January, 1786. As we know that he's tolerant, religious minorities will thrive during our regime, and he's a well-connected man, which our court of cabinet benefits from a wide network of among the great minds of this era of our ruler. So we could say he was a nice guy, but even though he has no military skill, some diplomatic, plenty of administrative skill, with very good advisors that would help contribute, hopefully, during this great war that we're part of. Which again, we originally envisioned a massive war between the Ottomans and the Mughals, but then we decide to escalate it in the sense of who's involved and how much of the world is involved and all that. Well, as it is a world war in a sense, meaning that there will be battles all over the world, Asia, Africa, and Europe. The exception are North and South America, because it's likely that they will be spared from a very devastating war that will likely, well, basically engulf the whole old world, except for the more isolated parts of the world, such as, you know, Sub-Saharan and Southern Africa and that half, or even one of the East Indian nations. They'll be excluded, consider themselves fortunate. Heck, the most stable place on Earth would be have to be, you know, the great American Kingdom of Florida. Well, technically it's ruled by a Portuguese culture, which makes them a primary culture. So, yeah. So, for this world war, so again, this is going to be the final episodes of the Delhi Mughal series, and we wanted to end that series on an extremely high note. Because I'm convinced that fighting against the Ottomans, I think we would have given them a very good shot at it. Even though the Mughal Empire has an aura of invincibility on them. But let's decide to, how about we bring all the other nations in the world involved, including the nations we have allied with. So, for the Mughal Ottoman Imperialist War, this is how many nations are involved. So I don't know what we call the Entente or a Central Power side, Allied Axis, whatever you want to call it. So on one side, Mughal Empire, the British colonies of Argentina, Alaska, Brazil, Colombia, Louisiana, Mexico, also the Polish-Lithuanian Commonwealth, British colony of Cuba, Dai Viet, English Columbia, Great Britain, Japan, Korea, Lan Na, Mongolia, British colonies of Newfoundland, and 13 colonies, and finally, Republic of Venice. So, based on the numbers that you see, we, on the Allied side, over 1 million infantry, with 357,000 cavalry, with 814 artillery in total. And obviously we have a massive naval advantage, more light ships than we could count, especially on the British, and plenty of transport ships to send troops all along. And those that don't, well, they stay where they are, unless they're landlocked. And we are up against the Ottoman forces along with their allies, which is the Ottomans, the Ottoman Empire, also against Athens, which is in Malta, and some HRE states of Augsburg, Austria, Baden, also another Ottoman ally, Bashkiria, Brabant under a personal unit of France, Brunswick, HRE state, Bukhara, Chagatai, two Central Asian states, Chu, a small Chinese state, Crimea, Dortmund, another HRE state, the big Italian Republic of Florence, the Kingdom of France, which has not gone revolutionary, fortunately, Republic of Genoa, Hormuz, Khorasan, Lorraine, Luneburg, Mamluks, Memmingen, Milan, Mohaus, Revolutionary Holland, Saxony, the HRE Emperor currently, Terre Australe, which is the French colony of Australia, the Papal States, Utrecht, Jharkhand, Yass, and Yemen, bringing them the total of over 800,000 infantry, but less cavalry on that, on their end, as they're more infantry oriented, but most certainly on artillery. But I would say, for different reasons, I would say the war in Asia will be the easy part, but the war over in Europe will be hard because of France and Florence involved, as well as Saxony as the HRE Emperor, the Holy Roman Emperor currently, as this current emperor is an old one, but has an heir to succeed, which could mean, will they remain the emperor, or will one of these electors will become emperor? Or does that mean that they will get involved in that war? Anyways, world politics aside, so yes, the Mughal Empire is allied with Great Britain, Commonwealth, Venice. Kilwa has not participated in this world war because they're currently at a separate war, which is considered a part of the Great War as a whole. Japan and Mongolia. Kilwa is currently at war with Mari, which includes fighting against the Mamluks and Khorasan. They've already defeated Yemen in that conflict. So, our opening moves. And plus, thanks to our spy master and the spy network and the trading spices, that we were able to get this size of the spy network so high that we know their positions. We know where their movements are going to be. And we'll see if they're going to shift towards Europe. We must advance. If they shift this way, pull back and let them come to the mountain fortresses that we have built, and then we will defeat them off of the mountains to our defensive advantage to kill off their manpower. That's going to be our strategy for the first 2 years of the war. Just to try to hold off long enough until Kilwa finishes their war, tell them to join the Great War, and then they will start putting pressure against Yemen, Hormuz, and the Ottomans. Mamluks to an extent as well. This is just to get them involved so that we will send forces to Egypt. And have I considered taking territories off the Ottomans? Yes. One would be Basra for center of trade reasons. Two will likely take parts of mostly Egypt, Mughal Egypt, especially here. If the culture is Egyptian, which it is, an accepted culture. It does help the reduction of visor costs and the ulema loyalty to us. So, and taking control of these two, because the Suez Canal here. The Ottomans have not built the Suez Canal, but we would like to control it so we can build that canal. So that way the Mughal Empire can intervene in European affairs whenever it wants to, like, say, help out the Commonwealth or Venice. But as the war begins on this very day, as everyone's notified, remember this day, ladies and gentlemen, February 24th, 1799. The first shots have been fired. Genoa and Venice in the Gulf of Venice. The Ottomans are taking out the a Venetian lightship. More Genoese ships taking out the Venetians, but they will soon be deployed en masse. While the Commonwealth has an inferior navy, but fortunately, they did place most of them out there. But their navy's not strong enough to take on the Ottomans. As we know, their strongest fleet is this one. So it would require cooperation between the British, Venetian, and Commonwealth navies to fight against the Ottomans. Our participation in the Mediterranean will have to come later. Especially they have to get through Genoa first. While we are aware there is a presence of an Ottoman navy on our shores. 30 light ships. And we have many of them, so Ranma will lead. And I'm thinking about merging these two into one fleet. One of these unassigned admirals, you'll be in this one. And the navy that's still under construction. Yes, still under construction. Will be led by him. And one more fleet to be led by him. So your opening moves. Take down this fortress, because Chu will be the first nation to be defeated. We're at war with Yarkand. So the armies are to stop drilling and get to positions. With this many forces out there, four armies are to volunteer. Get to the borders. And that involves you too. Every fortress must fall. And you two will be going up there, and you'll soon meet up with this one. And knowing that Austrial is at war, so you may want to get down to the Malay Peninsula till further notice, as we'll be moving these ships along. As the ships are still on their way to meet up with their fleet. So they'll be ready to be deployed. Bitan. This is to escort the transport fleet if we wish to attack French Australia. We can't knock them out of the war, but they got a massive force and a big navy too, so they're going to be a problem. Unless the Vietnamese can assist us. So we can take them out together. So we have to watch all fronts. Well, meanwhile, although you're almost fully drilled, but I need you all to be fully drilled to get ready for the Egyptian participation. And also to come to here, I want you to stay close. These forces that have not been ordered to move are just going to be kept in reserve. Well, actually, no. You'll get involved in this. And anyone at Fort Smutch is you too. And as for them, the Central Asian front, I mean, we have to look by, defined by subcontinents. Tatari, Central Asian front. Yes, Central Asia. So we'll move to the Central Asian front, which will fight that. But it's going to be the Caucasia-Persian front. That's going to be a very dangerous gamble. Italy, South Germany, Balkans, France are going to be the main battlegrounds of Europe. Egypt will come later, and as well as the Levant. eventually. But due to possibility of Australians, French Australians, to be invading on our backwoods, which we have not upgraded that, so that would become a handicap. But don't worry, Vietnamese are with you. Try not to worry too much. If we see any Australian transport ships, sink them immediately. So that would kill off some of their forces that are on board. What, sending an expedition to them? Well, that'll be incredibly difficult because they're a colony of France and they have the liberty desire, which I don't think they'll be free anytime soon because they're at war. They're not going to betray their masters. But we did send them officers. So yes, all forces are ordered to move. And I know we have plenty of generals, but if we want one general who is... Well... Well... Let me see... 4254... You're gonna be the one to lead one of these armies. I mean, yes, there's a 3-star, but we need someone who is capable. This one. What's your name again? Is Shah Alam Rahidun. You'll be assigned to this army. Because you have the siege skill. It would be wise to knock Bukhara out of the war first. So that way, the Mongolian forces will be of big help to us. So they'll be a big help to take out Yakan, Chagatai's lesser. And then when we knock Bukhara out, and then Bashkiria too, then it's... So that way we will get assistance from Mongolia, either to be sent to the front there, or over to Europe to help the Commonwealth. Or to wherever. So get ready to force march. Forces of Bukhara are massive, so we need to, you know, bring them on down here. In fact, I think he should also be transferred to the front, too. We're gonna take their capital first. And we'll provide cover. Their morale's not full, meaning they were involved in something that we're unspecified about. This is to blockade the Straits of Hormuz so they can't come across there. And there will be a contact over there. So again, we will only focus on what we're doing. Don't focus on what's going on in Europe. You only hear it by reports. So I want to know all my allies as well. So I'll know what they're up to. Yeah, kill our two. And Japan and Mongolia as well. Who else am I missing? No, you got it all. Just want to keep tabs with my fellow allies. Well, now I got one last thing to say as we're reaching the 20-minute mark as the war begins. We are a nation of the United. We are a multicultural empire. Even though there are those that we have not fully assimilated with yet, but we understand their reasons. And all I gotta say is that we know that over in Japan, they would be saying for their troops is fight as one under the Emperor. And Britain is rule Britannia. And you know, Commonwealth. Although it's kind of funny to see Commonwealth and Lithuania as a separate nation. Monastic order, so I think it must have been a holdover from the old Teutonic Order that I was probably not aware of. But we can't guarantee who and what turned into who. But I can tell you this. For the Mughal Empire, for the Empire of Hindustan, as we will be charging into battle, into the front lines, into this war of end all wars and all that, we will say, Hindustan Zindabad! Hindustan Zindabad! Hindustan Zindabad! Jai Hind! Let's do this! Oh, one last trick up in my sleeve. Horse artillery. Let's get the artillery combat ability up. Alright. Let's move out. The first action to have occurred on our participation. Jedi has entered into a military coalition against us. And so is Khmer. I guess that's due to aggressive expansion policies. But the question is, will they carry out this threat? So, Portugal. Viva la Revolucion. Portugal has gone revolutionary. So they were all moving down this way before the war started. So they had plans. Well, we told them, you're part of this war now. Heck, you can even see the minimap of the green, which is ours. Blue, allies. Red, enemies. There might be possible minor actions over the new world with the ships that are out there. Although there are a few leftover French territories in America. Okay, that one's French. That one's native. So yes, it's mind-boggling that Florida is going to be the nicest place to be in now. You're spanning from Florida to Texas, all the way up to Montana, I believe, areas. Upper Missouri. Around there, yeah. So you could say, if you want to be safe from the World War in neutral countries, take a vacation in either in Scandinavia, Revolutionary Spain, Revolutionary Portugal, or even the Kingdom of Florida. Anyways. We destroyed their navy. So the way is clear. So where are they going? Because they seem to be scattered right now. Heading our direction just as we predicted. But keep in mind, we do have military access that Mazandaran has been given, knowing this is a widespread conflict, so we can come across here. But hold your horses and elephants. Also, waiting for one more ship to be finished building. And the construction, so they'll be joining up this fleet, and these two fleets there will fight against the Australian Navy. Because they might send troops to our way. Great ord my tail. Okay, they're on us now, so. This area is grasslands. Which they taking a mountain pass? I'll lead the charge. Let's head over there. We'll just bypass it. And go to here. Let them take their time. So we're volunteering these two armies to fight off against them. Rest you stay. Athens recalled diplomats supporting an advanced. Well, of course, because war has been declared. King Angus and fall. Once they're done, again, they're gonna have to come and assist them. Need to get Yarkand, Chagatai, and Bukhar out of the war, and we will receive great assistance from Mongolia. And promise them territorial gains. Because I'd like to see them reclaim. If they have any cores to reclaim. If not, well then I'll be happy to give it to them. And it's gonna take a while for the Japanese to participate, as they've been on a colonization effort in Siberia. And fleets are scattered all over the Atlantic. So, as we look at the casualties, no ground casualties, just only naval actions on the first months. And of course, not related to the Great War. The Powhatan, they'll soon lose their territories and will be given to the 13 colonies, which will participate in the Great War if they have any ships. And now the Grand Ottoman Armada has been deployed. They do have a flagship. Again, it's going to have to take a great effort. So pressure's on both of them. And we're using quite a lot of sailors. Pull back. Brunswick. Yes, recall. Brunswick's already been in a war. Okay, peace has been accepted. So the British have taken care of the American natives, and so these territories are to be ceded to 13 colonies. In fact, it's all 13 colonies at this point. So this would strengthen their position and be given more ports, adding the possibility of them rebuilding their navy. If they could build transport ships, it would be great to see the forces of the 30 colonies, the Americans, to come to our side. And it also means the British will fully commit to the Great War now. Are they coming this way? Yes. But I fear they might come to reinforce on this siege. But again, they can't go through the Zagros. But we would like to take out Coruscant out of the war. So perhaps he should move in now. Head to Kashgar. We're moving in. We'll cover you. Again, they're weak, so they'll be easy. As long as Hormuz doesn't support it, which means they'll be forced to go to the other front lines where we can definitely fight them off. But it appears there are no forces up there, so we can bring the Rajputs down there. A force multiplier. Be careful. Austria's recalled their diplomats, so of course, there's no need for that now. Haven't heard a peep out of Austria. In fact, how many ships do they have for Terra Austria? 32. That's not enough to transport everybody. Maybe half of their forces, but... But are we willing to waste our time to send these two armies to go down over there? Oh, they are committing. Yeah, that's what I was worried about. And there are going to be more to commit. Again, their forces are massive. And they're going to be recruiting even more. And there's already one Ottoman army sent to Cornwall. But again, part of my plan to say first 2 years will be a defensive stage. The 1801 will be the year for the offensive to go through there, send an expedition to Egypt, and we'll get them to add pressure. But I only wish for them to join as well. They'll be a great addition. But I only ask of you to earn your trust to make joining the war more likely. If I could shoot curry favors with them. Not that I thought about it. I'll let you know in a month. I think the Japanese will assist the Mongols. It'll be easier. If I was defender of the faith, that would be, you know, that's only if we're fighting against people who are not Sunni, but we're fighting against fellow Sunni, which is the Ottomans, so, eh. Hey, despite the fact we just beat the heck out of you, at war with rival. Yes, I understand that we've taken your territories and all that. Oh, I forgot another thing. This is going to be the only time that we'll summon a diet, which won't expire until the remainder of the war, basically. So the Brahmins urge us to build a magnificent house of worship in Warangal, so that their followers might have an adequate place to congregate the province. The dilemma of Umar Khatt suggests that we fund the construction of a new textile manufactory. It's for the wool. The Mansab Dars request that we invest in the prosperity of lands in other lands in Lower Dua. Okay, you got me. In Lower Dua. Okay. What is the goal? Base manpower at least 4. Yes, you got it. So there's your free manpower reserves that you just got. And now we have a land maintenance modifier reduced. So we've got their loyalty. And if I'm feeling generous, if I were to... No doubt that I'll be taking more land of our... plans, I'll be sure to sell the titles and give the lands to those that they care. Their loyalty would be their most gracious. So they're throwing their lot at us. Perhaps you may want to, yes, do hold here. This area's mountains too. But if we try to help out... Oh... So they've picked their target, the one that's not of mountainous terrain. Maybe we should take some degree of territory. Especially if it connects to the sea. Like, if we can knock Coruscant out faster, then we'll gain... We'll be willing to expand to try to take these, another mountain pass so the Onryts can't get by those. Which they'll probably will. Okay. True. You wanted to lose? Pillaged. Okay, you got it. And it'll cost me a tiny bit of a diplomatic power. I'm not here for territory. I just want you out of the war. Based on allied casualties, we're already seeing deaths. Just hang on. Okay. Now you are to the system. Head to there. As we're about to participate in one of its battles. Move up. Stick together. We need to knock Bakar out of the war quickly. Take their capital and their forts. Just by any means. So it'll be easy for the Mongolians to assist us on the Central Asian front. Whereas they're now putting pressure on us. Tell you what. Add more defensiveness to all the areas that we made states of. Defensive edicts. This is just to hold it off. Just to show that we are willing to defend. On this part. There. If the line breaks, then pressure's on us. It's just we need to take these nations out first, and then we can get some relief. Throwing their lot at us. So you may want to pull back. Pull back a bit. That area's gonna fall. The good news is that we drove most of the Ottoman forces away from Europe, so the Commonwealth will have an easier time to try to fight against the smaller HRE nations and help the Venetian forces to try to defeat the Papal States, Florence, and the other Italian states, especially Florence. Anything that are big contributors make our jobs easier. It's all up to the British. And those colonial forces out there, if they can get transports, which in fact, well, I know I have no idea. I'd be willing to send you money so you can get sailors, if you even have sailors. But based on its development in certain areas, well, there's a possibility. in Yarkand now. We'll soon be coming for you. Take this part. Take Kashgar. That's their capital. You know what? Bring all forces over. We're gonna have to knock them all out in a pitched battle. If we could defeat them here, I mean, they have to take the mountain. I mean, if they go through there, that means they would have a... Well, not quite, because they can't go through there yet. Just need to fight them at a precarious position that where they must fight, and we must have a defensive advantage over this. We have to. Co-op fighting against them. Got Starkrai Fairs of you again. Because we need to increase the trust so you can join us in this war, so you can fight against Yemen and draw some of the Ottomans over here. But you are winning. Where is their capital? Yeah, their capital's not been taken. You need to take the capital. And it's also possible we may have to begin sending reinforcements through there by sea, so stop drilling. Stop. Get to Goa. You two move in. Need to get on board soon as possible. Because we're running into a risk of, you know. Get over there. Need to combine our strength. Now we can begin the siege of Kashgar. So they're throwing everybody over there. Okay, they have not begun the sieging of Az, so this gives us time. So they can't go through these mountains. Even though those are belong to the enemy. And of course they're recruiting more and more regiments. Based on their direction, it's toward us. They've only sent one army to go over there. But the Commonwealth's already sent one army to defeat Crimea. Knock them out of the war, it'll be just a step. Venetians are handling it. These are mostly mercenaries, I see, based on those names. Power of the channel. And Vietnamese are recruiting newer regiments. Just to carpet siege more, and taking their capital to knock them out of the war would be good. Take Tashkent, which is their capital, then occupy a couple more, then then hopefully Bakara would be out. As the Japanese-Korean forces will also be on their way. So we've come to the realization that now they are throwing every single army that they have towards our direction. It's clear as day. Our first border fortress, so to speak, will fall. And we have to bring everybody over. There's no way we can... Alright. Just, is there a river crossing through Komorabad? No. Come on, hurry up. What the hell are you waiting for? You're not force marching. That's problematic. They're getting more and more numerous by the day, so we have to move in. Even I will take part. Results still. And we can't wait any longer. We'll be bringing all of our best, including the Army of the Rajputs. If we are defeated here, then we'll have to rethink our strategy. But at least it'll be to our advantage, as we will have the mountains. And as well as added pressure that we may have to... You know, get them to be attached to transports. To send them over to land in Aves to cut off their reinforcements. Which I think we should do that now, but the morale's not up, so... It's kind of too late at this point. We're committing this battle to try to drive them out of there. And they've just discovered our spy network. I'll add corruption to them. That'll be it. They knew what we were up to. We could have added more sabotage. Get in there. Defeat Coruscant as soon as possible. And I'll be willing to take a few territories, like this way. All the mountain passes. Basically all of ours. We're moving. Some are pulling back. Are they afraid? They've stopped. Due to lack of control of House Elves, they will be the attacker. So this is just a save. What? Everybody must force march. And there's another reason for that. A battle. And the steps. Small reinforcements. The Commonwealth has the advantage in morale. And siege specialists, which isn't going to do much unless they've successfully taken Crimea. But their capital's over there. Yeah, that there was naval action in the Americas. See, very few French remnant colonial possessions in North America. No sign of Australian fleet. There is French territories out there. Maybe it doesn't hurt to occupy at least one of their islands. Just to add small bit of war score towards against France. But beware. Australia might ramp up its navy. Would you look at that, an isolated force. Keep in mind, it's mount, so it's going to require a team effort. So they will be there on August 6. Check back on August 6. But right now, the focus of this big upcoming battle is coming here. In position. Move down. They actually have a border fort over there. But apparently they're not coming. They're just going to throw away their lot. All that for nothing. What do we do? Evenly distribute? Yeah, I think that would be wise. Evenly distribute. Make them go to the mountain passes where we can definitely have the advantage to kill off their manpower reserves. And killing their most experienced troops that are drilled. Because all these new regiments we see out there are the less experienced ones. Yeah, they clearly win this battle here. Well, we see nothing from Bukhara. I mean, they are said to have a big army, but it's nothing in particular that we're seeing out there. But we are around to back them up. Austria's got medium war enthusiasm. Who else? Yarkan. Well, as soon as they take their capital, it should be low enough to get them out of the war. Not there to take any of their territories either. Okay, they're committing. Again, battle begins on the... It begins tomorrow. In fact. So now they're pulling away. I think it would be a good time to send them over. Again, the way to the Persian Gulf is clear. Maybe they will make landings. To reinforce. Egyptian expeditionary force will wait until later. So we can split the forces up and apply pressure. As the Commonwealth will soon apply pressure into the Balkans. But that's only if the Venetians can hold. Because. Can't hold it forever from the Commonwealth. I mean, the manpower isn't as great as people would think. Kilwa needs to join. It could be the wild card. So, we'll definitely see this battle, and we'll send two armies to Sistan. Well, we're gonna kill them all here. Let's see it. Will others commit? While we're sending reinforcements through the Persian Gulf. Tashkent's been taken. Up. Our first major battle. Will they commit or not? really need some help him out with this. We're just clearing the way, and we'll eventually get to Chagatai, which it isn't much, but they got a sizable army, but they need to be taken out immediately. This hasn't been fallen yet, but it will one day. Being shipped over currently, so just gotta wait a few months. We have a higher discipline than they do, so how? So this will explain. That's the Dagger Monster Dodge system. Full quality, weapon quality standards are a visor and absolutism. The elements only have peace. So they just do not compare to Mugo discipline. Murad Shasing, battlefield medic, which will reinforce faster. They're gonna take a river crossing for this. And it looks like they will have to hurry up and get down here. But of course, every time you kill off their entire armies, that gives them manpower reserves back up to create even more regiments, although less trained. So we're killing off their best, most experienced troops, and they're just going to be conscripts, raw recruits, one would think. Commonwealth has won that one. Remember that day, August 6th. Check back. They actually sent a French expeditionary force in North America, I guess, to British Columbia. So I guess there is actions in North America after all. It is truly World War. They're sacrificing their lot. While the Commonwealth has almost have no manpower left to give, they're up their own. But if they're killed off, they're going to have to recruit newer ones. So Venice is being pressured. And again, it's only up to the Commonwealth to bail them out. I can't bail them out. Starts right now. August 6th. Battle is to be fought in Lhasa. And take out another one of their fortresses. In addition to their capital. Or we're just gonna stick close together. But again, Chin Timur Sinan's is our best land general. We only send him out there just to take care of the Central Asian front. So the Mongols can help support us. So it'll make our jobs easier. You got it. So again, Murad Shasing, he's our man. Compared to Babur II. Which, interestingly, we named after the first Babur, the not only founder of the Mughal Empire historically, but also the man who made the Mughal Empire into a world power, a great power. As I said, hurry up and take their capital. And you'll win the war, then you'll join us. So we can put more pressure against the Ottomans. And you know those ships are still on the way, so we might as well defeat them too. But that's gonna take a river crossing. Is it not? Let's try to scare them out. No, hold it! Are they coming? Are they that stupid? Are they stupid or are they stupid? Don't they know what they just saw? Okay, now take their capital. And after the Khorasan, then these two armies are also going to cross the Hormuz Strait into Hormuz itself and knock them out of the war. Where is their capital? Here, Zufra. My god, they are. Those damned fools. Okay, we just want to knock Bakara, Yarkand, and Chagatai without a major fight, but there's about to be a major fight. There is an army, but also mercenaries stationed there in Lhasa. Commonwealth forces about to maul them. It all depends on who strikes on their last nerve. And the French also send an expeditionary force to Alaska. What the heck are the French doing? They're leaving some parts of their homeland defenses, but I guess they think they'll be feeling fine. So, as I said, actions in what region? There is action in California and Cascadia. Another front line that we did. The most unlikely front line of this entire world war. That's just only its first year. But it's only the Asian front. The Central Asian front is the one that makes the most sense. But now the Mongols are about to participate in the battle. As you can see, the uniforms of the age. So they're about to fight them here. Well, coming August later. Wow, actions are also taking place. As I said, we gotta scare them out. We're gonna take a river crossing, but we will be receiving green. Enforcement at sea. Hold on. Wait for it. When the shooting starts, then send in reinforcements. Let's see. Now. They'll be there on the 28th. So, battle begins 27th. Reinforcements arrive next day. Another huge battle here. And they continue to recruit more. Basically, you are facing the army of the infinite. Well, the only way to defeat that is for all nations to come together, but you gotta defeat these European nations first, which is up to the Venetians and the Commonwealth. They're heading to Crimea, which also helps. But I say is, come on. I mean, your ally, Adal, is currently in the capital. It's about to fall in 19 days, we predict. And soon the war will be over and you'll get the notification that says Killua is ready to join the war. And then we can apply pressure to fight off Yemen, Hormuz, Ottoman Egypt, which we still plan on sending those forces out there. But now it's of the utmost of interest to defend this fortress. Reinforcements are here. Kashgar has been fallen. Pressure's on them. Mongols will soon defeat them in this battle, while another hard battle is taking place up in the mountains. But even though we have no generals there, but they have the mountains, so that could be a definite handicap, because they got a lot of morale to the Holy Wars. Yeah. I mean, after all, they're the lesser forces. To Chagatai capital. Move up. It's about to fall in 2 days, so we'll check back in the battle in a bit. Talus. Okay. Oh my goodness. You better hurry up. How much can we... How long can we hold them? You've been getting bad rolls lately. They're getting the best of us. Now enemy reinforcements on their way. We're getting cut off a bit. They've sent in fresh reinforcements, but more reinforcements will be coming. Be there in 7 days. Can you hold 7 days? They've got their general replaced. They're losing our morale here. Because they're mauling us with infantry and artillery. That's all we're willing to send, but, again, we all may get pulled back to different areas, and this area will fall. Fire. Vasum has to fall. Last fortress for them to take. And after that, Yarkand is out of the war. And so that way the Mongols and them will be able to assist us. That's why the first year of the war will have to be defensive, and it's going to be the hardest. But we had the morale, we had the tactics, we had the discipline. Just bad rolls on us, and they got a lot of artillery. They got a lot of firepower than we do. Got a good roll, but is it enough? It's during the fire phase is the one that's killing us. They got a very good roll against us. We'll replace in a moment. Nope, they got it. They got us. Pull back. Pull back to there. All of you. Get out of there. We've killed a lot of them, but their combined forces got the best of us. But again, these are replaceable losses. We can hold off longer. It's just the problem is they brought their A game up. They really committed their numbers to front lines. While we've split all our forces, but soon, when we take care of the Central Asian Front, they have to come down and reinforce the Caucasian Persian Front. While subsequently will knock Coruscant out of the war, and that we will have control of the seas. French forces are in Venice now. But Venetians are refusing to move. So again, it's up to the Commonwealth, as I said, to bail him out. The British can't go anywhere, despite their numerical superiority. In fact, how many transports do they have? Is Great Britain? No, excuse me, this way. 71. And where the hell are they? I'll tell you where the hell they are. They're up there. Fighting the North American front, and those colonial troops as well. That's where they're committed. And British Army are in other different areas. In fact, they have just transported this many men to fight against French colonial territory along the coast of Gambia and the Grand Coast. Okay, so Africa is another front that I'll be participating. Okay, you know what? Pull back. We gotta reinforce. Some of you are beginning withdrawals. New Admiral. It's gonna take a while for all of us to recover. Some are retreating there, the others will be retreating to Tabriz. Good. These are the areas that we want to retreat to. Areas that makes the most sense. So they got us. Get out of here. Damn it. That's all I gotta say. That's what we feared. And it was gonna happen. There's Bukharan forces now. First contact, but are we really gonna fight against them? In fact, see too if you can call them up. Austria has low enthusiasm because of revolts. Negotiate Austria. Do you want out of this war? Austria will send Unterkarten to Venice. Austria can't do this war anymore because of ongoing revolt. I don't know what it is, but possibly revolutionary. But they'll say yes to it and no money demanded. That's what we want to hear from you. Wait one day? Okay, just for more. We're just going to stall for time to try to negotiate some of the warring factions out of that war. Check their war enthusiasm of everybody. Yarkand, Coruscant, Mamluks are in the medium. If Yarkand wants to be out of the war, which would be great, but I think taking that fortress of Lhasa will further convince it. So, 10 days. Wait 10 days. Because we're on a retreat here. Just to guarantee that Chagatai will be out of the war, then it'll be easy for Mongolia to participate. And once we're done with them, then try to defeat the Bukharan armies, which we have not encountered them in a battle yet. Again, Japanese and Korean forces are still taking their time to move out. But no doubt they'll be of great support, so hopefully we'll turn around next year. What the hell are you doing out there? Keep going to retreat. Don't stop here. Don't stop here. They'll kill you all. So they... Again, they've chosen the most defenseless area. The one that has drylands and grasslands. They don't want to take it to the mountains. And if they were to take it to the mountains, then advantage us. Throwing this lot. Just try to build a fortress. It's even though it's not going to be finished till war's end, but we still have a few mountain fortresses in different areas where these are defendable should they send their manpower this way. Breach it. Taking their capitals will knock Coruscant out of the war and see if we can make a few territorial gains, such as these mountainous areas of Persia. Of Persia proper. Croatian separatists, that's what's going on with the Austrians. Plus, they weren't that big of a contributor to the war anyhow. Has not fallen yet. But again, we're pulling back, so we will begin to provide support to reinforce this front line. As we did increase the defensiveness as part of the edicts we assigned, just to stall the time during the participation. Wherever they attack, we will back up this force, so we're not pulling everyone back just yet. There is one more Bukharan fort that has to be taken. Again, we have the naval advantage, but it's the Ottoman Navy is going to be the huge problem. What the heck are these guys doing? There's no advantage in this. And the Venetians are rather timid. Maybe I ought to send them money to get so they can hire more mercenaries, so just to give them hope. French army in Mexico. And the other question is, you know, during this great war, where does Florida stand in all this? We know who they're allied with, and they couldn't help them out. But I guess honestly they don't care, but they do give France access, which I find that problematic. It's probably how they got in. And the other great power, Scandinavia, where do you stand? Probably be more sympathetic to the enemies that we are fighting. But they're only poor relations with other neutral countries, so that doesn't concern us. Or the Commonwealth. One bit. Again, waiting for Lhasa to fall. So their war enthusiasm will be low, so they'll be more than likely to surrender their possessions. And we got a lot of men to reinforce. And all that. So as we retreat, they're gonna take their territories. Possibly a few. while we wait eagerly for other countries to. Chagatai should be out. Crimea's war enthusiasm is low. Okay, there's another. Two stones of one bird. Chagatai. You will cede some territories to Mongolia. It used to be pillaged by Mughals, which is us. It'll cost this much. So, as of November 14th, Allied casualties is 216,000. To the Persian front. The Caucasian Persian front. Gotta move out. Now, Crimea is gonna be out too. Here it is. Reparations and all treaties with the Ottomans. And pay ducats to us. You got it. So in 13 days we'll begin negotiations with Yarkand for their exit of the war. And then after these two are done, in fact, you two begin. Going to there now. Whichever path is more convenient for you to travel. Actually, I've not defeated Bakara. But one day you will fight against them, so we got one more Central Asian nation that you have to defeat. And after that, then, Japan and Mongolia, Lanna, Daiviet will be assisting us. Coruscant's about to fall. So we'll negotiate with them in 12 days. And also move up for further operations. I'll defeat their ships at sea. National Bank in trouble. Our National Bank is doing very poorly. It's fighting hard to lend reliable people and running into difficulties. That's a lot of money. And look at them fort maintenance, army maintenance, all that harbor fees and all that. What's the harbor fees going to bring? Trading in gems also helps. Tell the bank to lend slightly less reliable people. That amount of inflation affects the fort maintenance. Coruscant flagship sunk. Good riddance. We sunk them all. Rest up here on this coast. While this continues to blockade. They're throwing every single one of them this way. While some are just going all kinds of directions. But I fear now they're putting pressure on the Commonwealth. While large battle in Poznan. Which they are moving in. So no doubt the combined forces of Florence and Lundberg will be defeated by the Commonwealth. Hopefully in time before French arrives. There's another hard battle taking place over there in Brno. Venetian forces are moving into Papal State territory. And if they can try to get the Papal State out of the war. Even though they're not really one of its bigger contributors. now to this stage. Okay, diplomat is here. Want Coruscant out of the war immediately. They won't give up territory. Even though we have not occupied. Okay, what do you want then? Well, really? Hang on here. Suggest demands again. What the? Without occupying any forts in the area. That's insanity. Can we just say white peace? And say all this was for nothing? You know, I would love to have some of their territories, but... well, I guess you get what they mean. Plus, it's an old castle. You know what? Do get down there. And take it. These three armies, including the 8th army, those are the ones that was from the ones that are meant to go to Egypt. Lhasa is over. Yarkans won't do this himself. Okay, negotiate with those guys. Yarkan, what do you want? To Mongolia. These territories are to be sent to Mongolia to help further their expansion. Obviously, number of allied casualties is increasing. Let's see too if we can get that old fort before they take it over, which they will, as they're throwing each every one of them. Of course, that means it's open season for that. Well, we'll try to have everyone recover. Yeah, we're just splitting everybody up for now. Until we get further rest and further reinforcement from those forces. So that way we can try to get Bakar out of the war, because they do not appear to be... I mean, their morale is still high because they have not... our army has not been tested yet. In fact, they went to Commonwealth. Crud! 4 days. Give us 4 days. Also, excuse me, to there. The vast majority of armies are to be sent to there. That's where the main battlefield is. And we heard nothing from the French Australians. I don't know if they even sent forces at all, unless they went to go, I don't know, fight against British Islands there. They're turning back as Bakara, so I think they know what we're doing. I think the French are going to defeat the Commonwealth out there, as they're sending reinforcements this way. But the other enemy forces in Poznan have been defeated. Get your running boots on, all of you. Storm Laristan. It appears that they are now pulling back, knowing that it's like, okay, that's too much for the attrition. Now they're going to have to begin besieging this fortress, and the mounds are open for them. Open through there, at least. But if they start taking over mound fortresses, we will have the defensive advantage, not this. Because them fighting in the mountains will be very hard for them, and it'll be easy for us. You're winning this war. Come on, what are you waiting for? End it. When Kilwa joins the war, then that means they're gonna have to send some of their force over there. Another front line for them to cover. It's just, I don't know if I have any faith for these European forces. They got the manpower, but now they're just taking their time to... Some ships on Terra Australia. All their light ships out there. French fleet defeated out there, but that's transport fleet. Continuing to roam around. And way up in Alaska, the most unlikely front line. They're about to take a river crossing and a mountain crossing, so no doubt those forces all the way up north in British Alaska. It's got to be winter up there, isn't it? Yes, normal winter. The northernmost battle has taken place in western Alaska. Eyak, western Alaska, Cascadia. American culture, so. Led by George Byron. As we see the man's name. So, yeah, it'll be in February then. If they're willing to commit, because they're walking this way. Yeah, and that coming February, the northernmost battle of the entire war. I don't think there's going to be anything like that ever again. While we continue to draw up battle plans for 1800. Jain influence expands. Many influential Jains have found a home in the court of the Mughals. Jain ascetics, bankers, and merchants alike have the ear of the Padishah. Even there are rumors that Babur II himself has joined in Jain rituals. After all, he's a tolerant man. Though a small religious minority, Jains are getting power in politics and society. Every little bit of that influence helps. So again, we're convinced that the Ottomans are the army of the infinite. But we have to defeat them in pitch battle after pitch battle. And also knock out all the other allies, especially France, which is going to be the hard one to crack. But now Ottomans are moving their way. So we need to get Bukhara out of the war. Same for Bashkiria. And then things will be good. And I see that they're moving in the direction towards the mountains, so this is to be our advantage. Karakunulu has not given access to anyone. They will not let anyone in. No way, no how. It almost makes me want to go to war against them and just say, enforced military access. At least Mazandaran has given us access. Japanese forces are on their way to take this mountain castle. You do have some siege skill and you got plenty of cannons. And Mongols will be with you soon. wide open country. So I think that's their last fortress that we'll have to take, and pressure be on Bakar. So we'll advance. So we're gonna stick together and finish the Central Asian front. Once Bakar is out of the war, then I guess we could send at least two armies to Bashkiria. Take this and this and those forts. Then they'll be out of the war too, and it'll be easy for the Commonwealth, so they don't have to cover their back anymore. There'll be no Christmas truces here, but when we recover, we will have the advantage. Spymaster has passed. He was a good man. Unless you want another spymaster. Which, quite honestly, I think that would be for the best. Because we may never know, we'll start rebuilding that spy network. And try to mess with the Ottomans a little bit. I don't want to construct another one, but you don't need to improve relations with Mongolia anymore. Got what you want out of them. You need to free up more diplomats. If only we had mysticism, that morale of armies and fort defense would be a great difference maker. But we would lose the manpower. So, just to get you guys ready. Contact! Bukharan forces. We gotta turn around. They'll be knocking down that last Bukharan fortress. Defeat the large Bukharan army here, and then that will lower their war enthusiasm. Oh, we done made a mistake. But soon, we'll make a difference. We'll just be crossing a river. Actually, there'll be no river crossing here, but we will catch them. Battle will begin on the 28th. Which is these guys over there. So we're not going to get all of them yet. Knock it down. Take another fort, then Khorasan will be out of the war. Mazandaran's declared war against Karakunulu. Nationalism. World at war, isn't it? Okay, head to Ardalan. Everybody must meet up again. But I fear that this would put pressure on us, because we're not fully reinforced. We will have the mountains advantage, but will their numbers matter despite the advantage that we'll have? Take out one army over there. And they're gonna try to rescue them. It appears they've lost a battle recently, likely against the French. Lorraine and Genoa are there. Again, increasing the trust, which means added opinion and more likely to join the war that we can call for. Mamluks and Hormuz are plentiful. Forces of Yemen, they got a lot too. Don't forget we're at War of Yas. Once you get take down this fort, maybe we can fight another separate battle to cut off the reinforcements and all that. So we'll be ending this episode on the 1 year anniversary of that war. Unless we can scare them out. People sampling new religions. Our policy of encouraging innovation and free thinking has led to people taking a more relaxed attitude to the state of religion. Reverse course. We don't need any more unrest. We don't want to have that in our conscience. Oh, good lord. Well, you are committed to this battle. You got yourself into this. It's that large Bakaran army. Take the river crossing penalty. Battle begins 28. Be there at the sun, but I fear they're going to be mauled. Coruscant's war enthusiasm is low. Well, we need that fort taken. Oh, God blasted, what are we doing? We'll be there on the 29, but it's going to take another couple to get there. And there's no friendly reinforcements nearby. The Mongols won't get there fast enough. So our next major battle's focus is going to be there. Oh, God! Bringing the best general out there. You'll be there on the 20th. What are we doing? What are we doing? What are we doing? Coruscant is out. It's good to know that you're giving me this amount of territory. Adds the overextension. But, don't want us to take a mountain fortress, but few mountains ourselves is just fine. Don't really need that one. Would like to have this, but that'd be cut off. But oh well. It's nice to know that we can have a connection now. And a few mountainous territories. But none for there. So it'll cost us 200 diplomatic power for this. Okay. 291,000. As we are soon reaching the 1 year anniversary of this war. So it'll be done next year. Don't mind separatists. But take up positions here. As we're beginning to roll around. Any of them that are still marching? Well, took you a long time to get here because you didn't force much. I'll also go with them. This is just to add a lot more pressure. Well, meanwhile, we just did a military blunder that's going to cost the entire army there. Yes, you did. All 30,000. It was the cavalry support force. We can't stop him, but we got a damn good general. Got blasted. I mean, the shock will do very well. But can we wait for reinforcements? Such a smaller force can defeat them. we got good rolls, good discipline and all that. But still, we're under pressure. Reinforcements are about to arrive, so this will relieve us, and they're out of here. Jintemo Sinan, inspirational leader. Recover armor speed, so there you go. Move up a little bit. You know, none of you are fully reinforced to standard. But we're beginning a big offensive. Counter-offensive, hopefully. Separate conflict between Austria and Bavaria, former participant of that war. Actually, now, ladies and gentlemen, that's going to be the end of this episode, as we will stop on February 24th here. So that's the one-year anniversary of this war. Again, we can't be certain of how many total casualties are on the enemy side, but we do know it's a lot, and things are about to get nastier, so... So at the beginning of spring of 1800, so it's likely that there will be two big battles that we're trying to get everybody participated in very soon. As long as the fortress doesn't fall, otherwise that'll be a problem for us. But we have the mountains now that we have access to. So as we will take a look real quick. Oh, and by the way, the Battle of Norilaska, well, Army of the Yukon Ups. So they did defeat the British Alaska Fortress. They probably weren't drilled, and they had some experience. Army of the Alps, so they came from French Alps. So that was concurrent with that stupid battle, but a dangerous one. So if you've already lost one army, but the Mongols now have free reign of the plains. As that last Bukharan fortress appears to be taken, as I don't think I see any more forts as far as who owns what, but defeating their large army in a catch battle would be a very good sign. But they need to occupy a lot more territories. And we know that the Mamluks are also at war with Kiowa, as some of their territories were occupied by them. So we thought maybe we should get them out of the war. I mean, Kiowa Armada. So they're about to get involved in forces of... Okay, you know what? Get the Mamluks out of the war if their demands are good. But unfortunately, there is no demands here. There's nothing that we want from them, because we have not occupied any of their territories, nor their war score. In fact, I don't think we even fought them in a battle at all, but they were led by it. So again, ladies and gentlemen, as we will end the episode on that. The total casualties on our side, 319,000. 62,000 due to attrition. Lost 87 ships, mostly British and Venetian ships. But nonetheless, our war enthusiasm is high. We've already knocked out some of the countries out of the war, but these are just smaller entities, including Arkand and Chagatai. Yes, they're out of the war. So now we're going to put pressure into Bakara. So there'll be two focused front lines at this point. Central Asia. And in the next episode, the Persian front is about to fire up again. With two intense battles. And there'll be more enemy reinforcements to be heading this way. And they'll never join our war. But at least they'll be fighting a separate conflict. They gave them access. You know, not bordered with them. So, again, the objective is to take Constantinia. Which, honestly, that would be up to the Commonwealth to get there, not us. Because we're going to have a much harder time with this. As more reinforcements will be on the way. And I think we may want to forget about the Australian participation. But I think they are going to participate, too. Well, these two armies here, we're going to have to put them transports in. And these two there are going to be sent to there. In fact, begin preparations. So, as we know, ladies and gentlemen, a spring counteroffensive will soon begin. As these armies will be picked up by transport to be sent to there. We're committing nearly all of our armies there, with only some remain. Central Asian front, as will be assisted by Japanese, Vietnamese, Mongolian forces to get them out and get Bashkiri out of the war. So it'll be a lot easier. And then Kilwa, hopefully in 1800, joins the war. So that was part one of the Great War. Part two will be during the year 1800. So hope you people join us, because it was not good for us, but hopefully we can come back out of this. And until then, so long for now.